So let's look at the first and probably simplest form of hydrogenation, and that would be what we call full saturation. What that means is that I'm taking a double bond or a triple bond and I'm fully saturating it with hydrogens, all right? We can do this by two different reagents. We can do this with either catalytic hydrogenation, which would be these reagents right here in the first arrow. That would be basically H2 over a platinum, palladium, or nickel catalyst, okay? Or there's another reaction we can use as well called Wilkinson's catalyst. And Wilkinson's catalyst is used really for the same purpose, to take double bonds and triple bonds and fully saturate them to alkanes, all right? So as you can see, the reagents for Wilkinson's catalyst are a little bit confusing. It's got the H2, because we're adding hydrogen, of course, but the catalyst is way different. In this case, we're gonna use rhodium with these like three triphenylphosphines and then a chlorine. It looks messy, okay? I'm not gonna draw the whole thing for you. As long as you can recognize that that's Wilkinson's, that's fine, okay? So now the only thing about full saturation is that this is a little bit of a misnomer, because remember that rings also count towards unsaturation. A ring is something that it's missing two hydrogens because two ends are attached to each other. And actually, these reactions do nothing to rings. So what's gonna happen is that all the double bonds and triple bonds will be gone, but the rings will stay intact, all right? One more thing before I draw these products, notice that the stereochemistry says syn addition, okay? Syn addition is another way to just say that we're gonna get cis products. So what that means is that I would expect the hydrogens that we're adding to add from the same side of the double bond or the same side of the triple bond. So let's go ahead and draw our products. Basically, I would get the same exact sigma framework. When I say sigma framework, I'm just saying all the sigma bonds are the same. But now I would get a single bond over here, so that triple bond just turned into an alkane. And I would get that this alcohol is still here. And then I would finally get that that double bond is also gone, meaning that there's no pi bonds left, okay? What this is really good at is getting rid of pi bonds. That's pretty much it. So here I did include stereochemistry because there are no chiral centers, so I don't really have to. But if you're wondering where did these H's come from, especially maybe on the double bond, they could have both come from the same side. So that means, like, let's say that one of the H's came from here and one of the H's came from here. Notice that they came from the same side of the double bond, then that means that my alcohol would be forced to go down. Okay? Alternatively, I could have also had the H's add from the bottom, which means that the OH would have gone up as well. Same thing with this, with the triple bond, except with the triple bond, I added four hydrogens. I didn't just add two. So I basically added, let's say, two from the front, HH, and I also added two from the back. So let's say HH. So what I wound up getting was, instead of, and then also, so now the, this carbon here makes sense as CH2. But this one looks like it doesn't make sense because it's also CH2. But remember, there was already one H to begin with on that triple bond. So that last H is still there, and it's right next to my head. So does that make sense? Basically, I added the two blue hydrogens, then I added two green hydrogens, and then this black H was just always there. All right, so basically you can think that full saturation, or one of these two, catalytic or Wilkinson's, is gonna completely get rid of all pi bonds, all double bonds and all triple bonds. Easy, right? Cool,